Hey everyone, Reed here. Today I'm very excited to showcase a new feature for Power BI Desktop. Power BI now includes a menu for customizing themes and formatting, plus with the ability to export that file as well to share. This feature has been heavily requested for a long time, and I'm very happy it's finally part of the product itself. So let's hop into Power BI and I'll show you how it works. So what I have in front of me is the same file that I used to showcase the new themes that were available that came out a few months ago. Just to give you a quick reminder that some of the ones that we can see here, including that really nice dark theme as well, and just a few others. I'm not going to go too far into the other new themes that we had available that came out a few months ago, but if you're interested, I will link you to the video over here on the right. But the focus of this video is that I want to talk about the idea that there is a new way to customize the themes built into Power BI Desktop. If you actually hit this dropdown here, you'll see a few options down at the bottom. I can browse for themes, there is the theme gallery, but there's also an option to customize current theme, and as well to export it if you do any customization. So if I click this, what it does is it opens up a pop-up window that says customize theme and then gives you a ton of options to go and customize in here. And I'll walk through just a few of them. We do have an option here to name the theme itself, and it does have this series of primary colors that will have those gradients in there. What's nice is it also now includes the sentiment colors. So for any things that you actually have positives and negatives showing, you can choose the default colors there as well as a neutral. Any divergent colors that are used for conditional formatting as well, the defaults can be set here. There's even some options as well for advanced if you're actually formatting the table or the matrix visual, and it actually has the different levels of elements in there on what colors those will be in terms of the rows and the subcategories. So it's really nice to be able to have all that, plus some learn more buttons as well. And on top of all this, you also have things for formatting, not just colors in here. So you can actually format the text on what the general default font family, font size would be, as well as customizations for the title, the cards and KPIs, even the tab headers as well. And even some of the visuals will actually get some default customizations you can apply into here that will be set anytime you create a new visual, such as the background, border, header, and even the tooltip formatting as well. There are some page settings too for the wallpaper and background, and as well as some ability to customize that filters pane as well. Now, this is a preview feature, so it does need to be turned on in the File and Options menu. So if you go to Cancel here, go to File, go to Options and Settings, go to Options, and if you go to Preview Features, you will see that there is Customized Current Theme, so that does need to be turned on. But other than that, you'll have a theme that you'll be able to create into here. As I mentioned, it is evolving and it is in current preview mode at the moment, so that will also mean that some new features and even the menus and everything else might change a little bit, and I'm sure it's just going to get even better with more options to customize. Now, what I've also done for you is actually included a theme file, the one that I have and I built for this video, and just ones that I use in most of my reports. So I'm actually going to browse to it and I'll just show you what it looks like. I'm going to go ahead and just get to my theme file itself. So theme creator, files, there's my Havens Consulting theme. And you probably will recognize this from a lot of the other reports and stuff that I've built. In general, it has that really light gray background that I like. It actually fills in all the visuals with a solid white color and just general formatting as far as the headers and everything else. So that will be included if you sign up or already signed up for my blog and go to the files and downloads page. But other than that, that about covers it for this video. I just really wanted to be able to show that new theme creator, and the fact that you can export that as a JSON file, I think is a huge, huge change in the right direction, because so many companies are really wanting to do this, especially with them creating a standard theme for an organization. So this will be very, very helpful for those scenarios. And all I ask is that if you like this video, please click or smash that like button below. And if you have anything to say about this video or have a suggestion for a future video, add that to the comments section down below. And if this is your first time to my channel or you want to see more of these awesome videos, please click that subscribe and notification button. And otherwise, I will see you in my next video.